Now, Dalton, Mr. Rao earns rupees 12,560. He saves half of this amount. Half of this 12,560 he saves. If he saves same amount in every year, how much would he save in 10 years? So year, month, earning and saving of earning is given. 1 month earning is given and half of this earning he saves. Then we have been asked here what or how much amount he saves in 10 years. We should calculate how much he save in, how much amount he saves in 1 month. Then we should find the how many months are there in 10 years, that is 12 into 1 year is 12 months. So 10 into 12 is 120 months. We should calculate, we should find savings of 1 month. Then we should multiply this one by 120 months. Then we will get savings, total savings in 10 years. Now we will proceed. So 1 year is how much? 12 months. Because they have given year or time in months. So 10 years and here salary is given in months. So we should convert that years into months. So 10 years means how much? 12 into 10 is 120 months. Now we have converted 10 years into months, so we will find the salary of each month. Salary or earnings of 1 month is rupees 12,560 savings. Saving in 1 month. In 1 month is, we should divide this one by 2 or 1 by 2. That is 12,560 into 1 by 2, or we can divide it by 2. We will make this one two parts. If we divide this one by 2, we will get half of it. That is 2 ones are 2. Here this one is, we will write this one slightly below. See here, we will write here 12,560. We will make half of it. Out of 2, one part we will take. 2 ones are 2. 2 in one table, 2 is not there, so write 0. Take next one, it will become 12. 2 6s are 12. 12 minus 12, 0. We cannot write anything here. So 4. Here 5 is there in 4 table. In 2 table, 5 is not there. So 2 2s are 4. 5 minus 4 is 1. We will write here 1. It becomes, we'll, after taking next digit, it becomes 16. 2 8s are 16. 16 minus 16, 0. Nothing can be written here. In 2 table, 0 is not there. Less than 0 also not there. We write 1, 0 and take next digit. There is no next digit. So this is the rupees 6,280 is the saving in 1 month. Now we will get rupees. Now what we got? Rupees 6,280 saving in 1 month. Now saving in 1 month is this much. Savings of 10 years. 10 years or 120 months is how much we will calculate. That one, after multiplying this 6,280 If he sells in 1 month, if we multiply, how many months are there? Total it in 10 years, 120 months. If we will multiply saving of one month by 120 months, then we will get total savings of 10 years. That is, we will get 753,600 rupees he saves in 10 years or 120 months. Now we will find the product. What is the product of first 10 whole numbers? First of all, we should know what are the whole numbers. Then what are the first 10 whole numbers? Then we should find the product of these first 10 whole numbers. Now we will write what are the first 10 whole numbers. Whole numbers, natural numbers, even numbers, odd numbers, already we have learnt in previous chapter. Now we will recall this one, whole numbers. First 10 whole numbers are, first 10 whole numbers are, what are those? 0, whole number starts. The set of natural numbers including 0 is known as whole numbers. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are the first 10 whole numbers. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 numbers are there. These are the first 10 whole numbers. Now we will multiply this one. 0 into 1 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. So 0 into anything is 0. If there is 1 0 in between the product of some numbers, then the whole product will become 0. So now product of 10 whole numbers is, therefore product of 10 whole numbers is equals to 0. This is the answer. Now we'll solve 14th one word problem. That is, there are 256 pages in a register. Each page contains 35 lines. How many lines are there in the register? That is, one register is there. That is register or big notebook. In that register, each page of this register contains how many? These are lines. How many lines are there in each page? There are 35 lines in each page. How many pages are there totally in that register? So here this is first page and this one is second page. In this also 35 lines. So there were 256 pages are there in that register. So how many total lines are there? In one page 35 lines, another second page also 35. So 35 into, if we multiply this 256 pages are there, then we multiply 256 by 35 each page, we'll get the total number of lines in the in all the pages, 256 pages. So we multiply, or first we'll write data, how many pages, number of pages in the register is 256. So number of lines in one page, number of lines in 256 pages. Now we'll write data like this. Total number of pages in, sorry, not number of pages, number of lines, number of lines in one page. Number of line in one page is how much? Number of lines in one page, 35. Here given, see here. Each page contains 35 lines means one page. Each means one page contains 35 lines. That is, number of lines in one page is 35. You have to, we should modify while writing data some words so that your data can be easily understood. See here, number of lines. Here each page contains 35 lines means number of lines in one page is 35. So now number of, how many pages are there So totally 256 pages. We know how many lines are there in one page. Now we should find number of lines in 256 pages. So number of lines in 256 pages is how much? We should calculate. If we multiply number of pages is 256 by 35, we'll get, these are the number of lines in one page. So number of lines in 256 pages, if we multiply these two, we'll get number of lines in 256 pages, or number of lines in the register is, the result we get is 8960 lines are there. 8960. What is this? Here, last lines here. How many lines are there in the register? What we should write here? Therefore, number of lines in the register. Therefore, or total number of lines in the register you can write. Total number of lines in register is this one. This is the answer. 8,900. Now 15th one. At a mobile phone shop, 35 sets were sold on a particular day. The price of one set is rupees 1,225. Then find the total amount collected by the shopkeeper on that day. See here. ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಶಾಪ್ ಐತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ದಿನ 35 ಅಥವಾ 35 ಸೆಟ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ ಮಾರ್ತಾನ. ಹ್ಞೂ, ಅವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ದ ಅವು ಎಂಥವು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ದ ಕಾಸ್ಟ 1,225 ಅಂದರೆ 1,225 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅವ ಅಂದ ಅವಾಗ ಎಷ್ಟು ರೊಕ್ಕ ಬಂದು ಅಥವಾ ಅವ ಎಷ್ಟು ರೊಕ್ಕ ಹಣ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ, ಗೊಳೆ ಮಾಡಿದ ಅಥವಾ ಅವನು ಸಂಗ್ರಹಿಸಿದ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಡೇಟಾ ಬರೋಣ ಏನಂತ. Cost of one mobile set is rupees 1,225. Cost of 35 mobile sets is how much? Then after multiplying cost of one mobile set by 35 sets, we will get cost of 35 sets. See, I will write here. Now what will we write? First data. Cost of one mobile set is how much? Here it is given, this one, rupees one two two five. Then cost of how many mobile sets are there totally? He sold on that day 35 mobile sets. Then cost of 35 mobile sets is rupees how much? Cost of one mobile set is 1,225. If we multiply cost of one mobile set by 35, then we will get 35 cost of 35 mobile sets. Therefore, cost of 35 mobile sets is 4,2875 rupees. 4,2875. What we should write? Last sentence you should find the total amount collected by the shopkeeper. What we should write here? Therefore, total amount collected by the shopkeeper, or therefore total amount collected. Therefore, total amount collected is this much. Now we'll take 16th one. There are 60 seconds in a minute. Then find how many seconds are there in one day. One day contains 24 hours, or 24 hours makes one day. Now see here, 1 minute is there given. Now already we have learned that 1 minute is 60 seconds and 1 hour is 60 minutes. So 60 minutes is, if we multiply 60 minutes by 60, then how many seconds are there in each minute? 1 minute, 60 seconds. If we multiply 60 minutes by 60, then we will get total number of seconds in 60 minutes. That is 36. These two zeros, if we write 3600, it becomes, that is 60 minute or 1 hour. 1 hour contains 3600 seconds. If now we know that 1 hour contains 3600 seconds, then easily we will find that number of seconds in 1 day. That is, 1 day means what? 1 day means how many hours? 24 hours. 1 day means 24 hours. Now we'll find how many seconds are there in 24 hours. 1 hour makes 3600 seconds. So 24 hours is how many seconds? If we multiply number of seconds in 1 hour is 3600, then how many hours are there? Totally 1 day means 24 hours. If we multiply number of seconds in 1 hour by 24, we will get number of seconds in 24 hours. That is, after multiplying these two below this, we get number of seconds in 1 day is how much? We'll get this one. After multiplying this, we'll get 86,400 or 86,400 seconds are there in 1 day or 24 hours. The soap factory produces 6,955 soaps a day in 1 day. That is, in 1 day, how many soaps did the factory produce in the year 2020? If there were 82 holidays in the year 2020. First of all, we should know 2020 is a, whether it is a leap year or normal year. It is a leap year because in the month of February there are 29 days in this year. So this is a leap year. So total number of days in the year 2020 is 366 days. So first of all, we will write number of days in 2020, or number of days the year 2020 contains is 366 days. In normal years there were 365 days commonly, but in leap year, once in 4 years a leap year comes. That is, the year number which will be completely divided by 4, then it is known as the leap year. In leap year, the month of February contains 29 days, so we say it as leap year. So similarly, this 2020 is a leap year, so it contains these many days, 366 days. In these days, factory is closed, or holidays, there were 82 holidays, so factory will not run or work, or soaps will not be produced in the holidays. So we should take out the number of holidays from this one. So holidays are how much in 2020 are how much? 82. If we subtract these two, what we will get? Number of working days. That is, number of working days the factory will work, how many days we will get after multiplying, subtracting this one. This is 4, this is 8, this one is 284 days the factory will work. And now we'll write next one, number of soap cakes produced in 1 day and number of soap cakes produced in 284 days. Soaps or soap cakes, either are the same. So number of soaps produced in 1 day, we'll write there. Here it is given. See here, a soap factory produces 6,955 soap cakes a day means 1 day. So number of soaps produced in 1 day is how much? 6955. These many soaps were produced in one day. So number of soaps produced in how many days? Factory works 284 days. 2020 contains 366 days, but 82 there were 82 holidays. So if after subtracting 382 from this, we'll get 284 days working days. 284 days. Number of soap cakes produced in total 284 days is we don't know. We'll find now. In one day, 6955 soap cakes were produced, and how many days it works factory? 284 days. If we multiply 284 by number of soap produced in one day, we'll get number of soaps produced in 284 days. Now we'll write, after multiplying the 6955 by 284, we'll get number of soaps produced in 2020 is 1975,200.